translates this in is al-mustadrak. And remember mustadrak. What is mustadrak? Imam Hakim's mustadrak is a book of hadith in which he compiled narrations on the of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. So the conditions laid out by Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim himself says, in the Muqaddimah of Sahih al-Muslim, you can find that they did not compile, they did not gather all the Sahih hadith, but they made some sharait. So the other ulama, after the time of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, with the conditions of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim, they compiled the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was not possible for them to gather all the Sahih hadith in the time. But they laid out some conditions. They had some sharait. So Imam Hakim in his Mustadrak and Mustadrak, all the hadith of Mustadrak according to Imam Hakim are based on the condition of Imam Bukhari. The sharait of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. This Imam Hakim in his Al-Mustadrak narrates this. An Khuraym ibn Yaus ibn Harisata qala kunna 'inda an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fa qala lahu al-Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will give you the background to this hadith. This incident took place according to Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah. This incident took place after Ghazwa al-Tabuk, after the Battle of Tabuk. After the Battle of Tabuk, the companions, they gathered with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Sayyiduna Khurayn bin Aus radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he narrates, he says that we were with the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and suddenly Sayyiduna Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Sayyiduna Abbas, who is Sayyiduna Abbas? The uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I want to recite your na'at. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I want to praise you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave him dua and gave him permission to recite the na'at. Now, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah says, this gathering took place after Ghazwa al-Tabuk and it was a big gathering. It was a gathering in which there were 30,000 companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't say, why do you want to read my na'at? We've just come back from Ghazwa al-Tabuk, from the battle. That's not important. Singing praises of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not important. We've come back after such a great battle. So why do you have to waste your time on reading the na'at and doing what I'm about to mention, what he actually did? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say that. Unfortunately, we think that we are saving people from shirk and bid'ah by telling them that you shouldn't commemorate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This was not the mizaj of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him permission, and not only Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi gave him permission, but also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him dua. Sayyidina Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. Then he recited the na'at, and this na'at was nothing but milad. What is milad? To mention the miraculous incidents that took place at the time of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That is milad. That is milad. Two things I've mentioned. There are two parts to milad. Two necessary components of miladun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the second one. In the presence of 30,000 companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyiduna Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he recited, وَأَنْتَ لَمَّا وُلِدْتَ أَشْرَكَتِ الْأَرْضِ وَدَاءَتْ بِنُورِكَ الْأُفُقُ. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when your milad happened. Brothers, this is milad. This is milad. He said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the word milad, anta lamma wulidta, anta lamma wulidta, waw, lam, dal. This is milad. Those who are students of Arabic, they know this. Walada yalid, what is it? Wulidta, when you were born, meaning when your milad took place. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when your maulid took place, what happened? Ashrakatil ard, the earth became illuminated. The earth was lit up with your nur, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With your nur, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With your light. And the heavens, the skies were illuminated with your radiance, with your nur, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who said this? Sayyidina Abbas. This is a long poetry, a long shairi, a long na'at. And in every line of this na'at, every share of this na'at, he mentions the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This hadith is in the Mustadrak of Imam Hakim. About the conditions of Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. This hadith is also found in the Mu'jam al-Kabir of Imam Tabarani. It is also in Majma' al-Zawaid of Haysami. It is also in Sir A'lam al-Nubala of Imam Zahabi. It is also in the Hilya of Abu Nu'aym. Imam Qurtubi also narrates it in his Jami' lil-Ahkam al-Quran. And also Imam al-Halabi in his Sirah and Ibn Qudama in al-Mughni. This hadith, I have given 12 references for this. 12 references. How many companions celebrated the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? 30,000 Sahaba alayhim ridwan. In one gathering, they commemorated the Milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, what is Milad? What is celebration? If you study, if you check up the word celebration and commemoration in any dictionary, Oxford dictionary, you check that it means, what is the meaning of commemoration? What is the meaning of celebration? It means to preserve the memory of something that happened in the history. To remember something, to praise someone, even if someone has passed away or someone is living, something that happened in the history, to remember that and to praise that and to express your happiness. That's what celebration is. What were they doing? They were remembering the miracles that took place at the time of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They were celebrating the milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Remember, to get together and mention the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is miladun nabi. And that is exactly what the companions did. 30,000 sahaba alayhim ridwan. What does that mean? Do you know 30,000 sahaba is not a little number. No one from the sahaba got up and said this is a bid'ah. No one from the Sahaba said this is a reprehensible innovation. No one from the Sahaba stood up and said that this is shirk. You're associating partners with Allah Jalla wa Ala. No one. What does that mean? Mawlid is proven from the consensus of 30,000 companions of Rasulullah. And why should we even mention the companions when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam himself was present there? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself was present there. This gathering of Mawlid, it took place with the permission of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam himself commemorated it. He was part of it. Such a big jalsa took place. Two ahadiths have been presented to prove the permissibility of commemorating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Next, also Sayyidina Hassan bin Sabit radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the famous شعر سيدنا حسان بن ثابت وأحسن منك لم تر قط عيني وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وأحسن منك لم تر قط عيني وأجمل منك لم تلد النساء. You know تلد النساء ولد يلد تلد. What does that mean? يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, there has never been a better Mawlid than your Mawlid. خلقت مبرعا من كل عيب كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء. يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, your Mawlid was such that it was free and pure from all sorts of defects. He had no defects. Your Mawlid خلقت, you were created. The creation of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, in the sense the physical manifestation of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in dunya, how did it happen? It happened through the Mawlid of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the birth of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And what does he say? خُلِقْتَ مُبَرَّعًا مِنْ كُلِّ عَيْبٍ. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your milad was pure from all aibs, all defects. كَأَنَّكَ قَدْ خُلِقْتَ كَمَا تَشَاءُ. As if your birth took place the way you wanted it to happen. The way you desired your Mawlid, that is how your Mawlid was. So this was, there are many adillah on that. Many, many proofs to prove. But we have to define it first. What is the definition of Mawlid? It is to thank Allah for blessing us with the rahmah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and to mention the miraculous incidents that took place at the time of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is Miladun Nabi. That is Miladun Nabi, and that is established directly from the Sunnah of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti rahimahullah. This is the third hadith now. Al-Habi lil-Fatawi. That is the fatwa, the compilation of the fatwa of Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti rahimahullah in his Husn al-Maqsid fi Amal al-Mawlid. He narrates this. A famous narration, which is also, Imam Bayhaqi also narrates that, and Imam Bazzar in his Al-Musnad. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, an Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Sayyidun Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates, aqqa an nafsihi, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did his aqiqah. Aqiqah for himself. Now, Imam Suyuti rahimahullah comments on this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sacrificed a ram, and the reason behind that was to thank Allah jalla wa'ala. He sacrificed a ram, and you know that's what we do in the gatherings of Miladun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What happens? We feed people, don't we? And this question comes to our mind. But what if that is a bidah? Can we hold a gathering of Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Okay, we have proven the commemoration of the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But what about feeding people? What about giving food to people? For the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is that permissible? Imam Suyuti rahimahullah says, the Aqiqah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took place on the seventh day after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birth. The grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Abdul Muttalib, he is the one who did the Aqiqah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam 7 days after the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Imam Suyuti says, Aqiqah only happens once. He says, this gathering, this sacrificing the ram, the sheep, he said, this was the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is no little man, this is Imam Suyuti. Imam Suyuti rahimahullah. Hafizul Hadith, Imam Suyuti rahimahullah. I can deliver a detailed lecture about him. He is a great ashik of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Time doesn't permit me, we can say so much about Imam Suyuti rahimahullah, how he was connected to the beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the kind of qurb that he had for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This Imam Suyuti rahimahullah says this was the Mawlid of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Clearly establishes that to feed people in a gathering of Mawlid is proven from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. Why did he feed people? Why did he sacrifice the sheep, the ram? Why did he do that? To thank Allah for his Mawlid.